Welcome to another episode of Legend, Mystery, and More. I'm your host, Stephen Sindoni. In today's program, I will share a story about a man named Colonel Billie Faye Woodard, entitled Area 51 Revealed. The story begins when a good friend of mine meets the retired colonel at the St. Germain Foundation Reading Room on Mount Shasta Boulevard in Mount Shasta, California, in August of 2009. After listening to the unbelievable story, my friend calls me and asks me if I would like to meet Billie and listen to first-hand accounts of someone who claims to have gone inside of the hollow earth and met with its inhabitants. But due to prior commitments, I was unable to meet with Billie. Here is Colonel Billie Faye Woodard's story. I was first stationed at Area 51 January 28, 1971 through 1982. In that period of service, I visited the hollow interior of the earth 6 times, 800 miles deep. Upon my arrival to Area 51, I was indoctrinated, and soon after I met several of the underground shuttle operators that have a stature of 13 to 14 feet in height. The tunnels that traverse the world are built by a species of beings who have existed here before we, a very long time ago. Immediately on my arrival to Area 51, I was made aware of the tunnels and all the workings of the facility itself. They told me that the first 15 levels of the Area 51 facility were man-made, that levels 16 to 27 were already there. Nobody from our government made them. We were just facilitating them. My father had been stationed at Roswell. As part of my induction into the military, he requested that I be stationed along with him at the Pentagon. There, they said, we have a new duty station for you, which will be Area 51 Facility Nevada, commonly referred to as S-4. When I arrived at the Pentagon, I was a second lieutenant. When I left the Pentagon, they gave me the field commission as first lieutenant. After only 3 weeks of being there, they handed me a full colonel rank, saying you have to be a full colonel to be stationed at this next facility. There were 150,000 personnel in this facility, approximately 85% military personnel and 15% civilian. Following my arrival, I was taken underground and did not see the light of day for 11 and a half years. The walls of the tunnels are very smooth. If you are able to pull a hollow tube through a ball of clay, you can get an idea of how smooth. The walls have what is likened to a marble finish, which are made of a metal substance impenetrated even by a diamond drill, nor will a laser penetrate the surface. Remember, there was a time when we used to see truth movements from point A to point B on the Earth's surface continually. It was not that long ago. Stemming from Area 51, one shuttle goes out to the Pacific Ocean 350 miles due west of Mount Array, where there is a pyramid. Another shuttle goes to the Cheyenne Mountain facility. The length of a large shuttle machine is approximately 1/4 mile long. Interior inhabitants make use of these machines, a huge vessel for moving large numbers of people, beings, whatever, quickly. The smaller shuttle is 50 to 60 feet in length. This was the kind I was in. The speed of the shuttle is faster than the speed of sound. They can travel from Area 51 to the main interior of the Earth in less than 10 minutes. In 5 or 6 minutes, you are there. The materials used to make the shuttles is the same substance that made up the skin of the spacecraft at Roswell. The shuttles run on electromagnetic power using the Earth's grid lines. The operator of these shuttles were a stature of 13 or 14 feet in height, looked like us in appearance, but much more highly evolved and speak through telepathy. There are 7 civilizations residing in the inner earth which are governed by the principles of harmony. They understand they speak all languages of the earth. Their understanding of medical knowledge is phenomenal. As surface humanity enters into the coming fourth dimensional phase, the inner earth people will come forward and more deeply work with us on the surface. People on the surface who seek to reach the inner earth inhabitants through meditation will receive it. Children who are here now are being more capable of using the wholeness of their brain, which is in common practice in the interior. One of the first things they showed us in the interior was their capability of interplanetary travel and time travel. The basis of time travel is likened to bending space, which comes through the power of meditation and by the acceptance of being an unlimited being. If you train your mind at a subconscious level that you are an unlimited being, all things are possible. On the surface, capabilities to experience this infinite power are more easily awakened at such portals as Mount Shasta, which serves as a space-time portal directly to the inner Earth. Once in the surroundings of Mount Shasta, you are drawn into the harmonious state. In my experiences at Mount Shasta, the Telosians are projecting an aura of great harmony in a lovely atmosphere. Of all the things I saw at Area 51, 95% remain hidden from the public. Going into Area 51 is like going into another world. There is a network of tunnels underground that go all the way to Europe, South America, and through several continents. And there is intermingling of this great network of tunnels throughout the globe, of which many governments use. Is there a secret underground military base called Area 51 in Nevada? We may never know. Is the Earth hollow? There are many people who believe that it is. Thank you for watching today's program, Area 51 Revealed.